Hey guys, Dr. Carlo here. This is a video response by the comment by Tirziu, Dumitru. I hope I got that right. And let me like his comment here. Are there any risk of getting bone fractures while the bones are getting put back in the position? Of course there is. I mean, if you're not careful, you can actually break more of the bone. Usually microfractures, if you think about it, you're moving a fracture bone in segments and jagged edges across each other and cracking noses. You might have heard that during the video. So of course it could be a tiny little bone fractures. We don't worry about those. This kind of like cement that helps join the bones together and heal. It's big fragments. So that's why a lot of times we do a pre-reduction x-ray and a post-reduction x-ray. Because let's say there were only two fragments like that, and after the reduction there's three fragments, then you probably broke it during reduction. I never seen that happen, but it's one of the things we want for, like doing a shoulder reduction. And if you didn't do an x-ray first, then the patient, when you do the post-reduction x-ray, there's a fracture, they could claim that you actually broke during reduction. I have heard stories of doctors that think it's just a dislocation, they manipulate, they don't get the reduction in place, so they do an x-ray and it's broken. That's far more dangerous than that. And of course, the things to worry about with something like this is because you manipulated that bone, you can create some soft tissue swelling, some hematoma, and then the dangers of compartment syndrome. Remember the P's of compartment syndrome: pulselessness, paresthesias, paralysis, and pain out of proportion to exam. If you have any of those, then you want to worry that the pressure in that compartment is too much, which can cause ischemia to the limb, even a limb threatening crisis. When that happens and there's compartment syndrome, the compartment pressure needs to be released, which means they have to cut the skin or fasciotomy to release that pressure and increase the blood flow back to the arm. Of course, elevation, rest, cold packs will reduce the swelling and hopefully will avoid this complication. I hope this explains some of that which you asked in this comment. Keep the comments coming. I will try to respond to them as we go. Thank you. Bye-bye.